Okay, we're at the Halifax Public Gardens. It's September 17th, 2012. To people who are not observant, which is most people, everything looks pretty beautiful here. And now I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to show you. This is a follow-up video of the condition of the trees. So when we zoom in, and I'll zoom right in really close. And you look right up close to the leaves, you look, they're all burnt, discolored. And what I want you to see in this video is there's not one tree here that has beautiful green natural colors. They're all different shades of kind of like a pale looking green. They're all different colors. That fallout from Fukushima is doing this all over the world. And people aren't noticing. All the trees are dying. They're all unnatural colors. They've all got that burnt. If you look on top of this tree here, for example, the leaves are all burnt. This is not from a heat wave. We're up in Halifax here in Nova Scotia, and we really don't get heat waves here. And some people might say, oh, it's a drought. There's no drought problem either. We get enough rain. And you get all different shades of trees, and this is not the way they're supposed to look. I have other videos and pictures that I've done over the years here, the same time of the year. So, like this tree is not even green, it's got a gray. The other trees have got it, they look yellow from a distance, but when you go up close to them, as I'm doing right now, you go really close and you look at the leaves and you go, wow, look at that, they're all burnt or they're discolored on the edges. I wonder what condition what's going to happen next year, because all these trees are dead this year. Next year there won't even be any leaves on them. And if you look at the other videos that I've done, you know by now that this is for real. Everything's dying. Look at this. I'm an older guy, and it's really amazing that we live in a society full of stupid people that don't have a clue to look at anything. They come over here to look at the trees, but they don't see there's not one healthy tree that they're looking at. How can you admire nature when nature is wounded like this? So when I posted my pictures online of all the burnt and damaged trees everywhere, I get reports, and this is happening all over the world. In Germany, BC, Southern USA, everywhere. Everybody that's been leaving comments is saying they have the same problem. Through the USA, they're claiming there's 80% of the USA is in a state of emergency because there's no food growing. And they're saying it's a drought. It's not a drought. The people are being told that, so they will think, oh, that's why the leaves are brown or this and that. This happens and gets worse after every rainfall. I just hope that when you walk around your neighborhood, you start looking at all the trees and look at all the plants. It's not just the trees this is happening to. Like, you look on the ground right in front of me. This is like September. There's not supposed to be any leaves on the ground. They've been on the ground falling off trees all summer long. But do you think people ever look up at the tree to figure out why are all the leaves falling off? And if they were to look up at the tree like we're going to do right now, take a look at what you see. Look at that, all the leaves are all black, they're all diseased. And it's not a disease from the plant, it's from the air, the rain. That wasn't a good example. Let's see if I can get a spot where... There's a good one. So what do you see? Yellow leaves, brown leaves, but if you notice, they're curled up. If this was due to fall, or even a drought, the leaves wouldn't curl up like that. If it's fall, all the leaves change color at the same time, but they never curl up. So that's the tree that's right above me. Look at the leaves, they're all full of holes. I mean, everything, everywhere you look, when you start looking up close, you're noticing everything's dying. When I was young and I kept telling people, man, those nuclear reactors are creating nuclear waste that nobody can get rid of. And you get all these time bombs all over the world. Now they're paying the price. Look at this tree, it's like yellow instead of red. instead of green. Even this one, look at the colors on this. It's not even green. Everywhere you look. You have to actually look to see what's happening. Look, this is what the rain does. This is an acid rain, folks. This is radiation. It's giving a lot of leaves a reddish look. Every plant's getting affected in a different way, depending on the species. So here's that tree that I was talking about, and look at it. The leaves are all yellow. And this is not fall, because there are green leaves in there. So I'll try to give you another example here. Let's see if I can find a spot where I can zoom in so you can see what's really happening. There we go. Now, let's see if the camera will focus. Now, if it was fall, you wouldn't have yellow leaves, brown leaves, black leaves, and green leaves. Fall hasn't even started here, and it doesn't start for another month, maybe another month and a half. So now, look around this side. This big tree here, it's almost all dead. Like, all the leaves are really poor and thin, and this is the Halifax Public Gardens that has the best maintenance for trees and gardens and anywhere probably in Canada. So let's see, what else can I show you? Unless you go up close to the trees, you're not gonna see what's wrong with them. I'm rolling around in a wheelchair in case you're wondering what's going on here. Okay, I'm gonna give you an example of the burnt trees. Here we've got a tree that's all yellow back here. That's not supposed to be yellow, it's supposed to be green. But if you look at this one right here, see all the discolored leaves? Okay, let's go to a spot that's not moving as much. There we go. If you look up close, you see, oh, this is not natural. All the edges of the leaves are all curled up and all black and red and burnt. But like I said when I started this video, most people are not observant. They don't have a clue what even goes on outside their house, let alone in the trees and everything else. But I'm going to go down this path a little ways, and I want to show you something else.
Some of the grass is back there.
Yeah. Okay, actually, I'm going to start here. At a distance, the tree looks healthy. And you look up close, and what do you see? All the leaves are dying, look. Let's see if the camera will focus on this. But I'm going to show you something else a little further down. It's not just the trees this is happening to. This is happening to all the foliage. Flowers, plants, everything. Now up here, there's plants that are really damaged from the fallout from the rain. And here we go. So when you zoom in and you take a good look at these plants, you'll see what the rain's doing to them. There you go, look at this. You gotta get the camera to focus. Now what do you see? See the end of the leaves are all burnt, then there's yellow and there's green. That's not how plants go into fall. And we'll do this one now. See? You've got green ones, and then you got these other ones that are dying. The rain does this. I have pictures of this plant up close, so you can see what's going on. So now, I'm looking at how much time I've got on my video. I don't want to make this video too long. We're at 10 minutes already. It's a fairly long video already. Okay, I'm gonna rush over to another part. I'm going to show you another plant that's really, really been damaged by what's coming out of the rain. I mean, it doesn't matter where you go. Look, I can come up close here and you can look at this. And people think that this is natural, okay? Yellow, reds, all this colors. There's nothing natural about this, folks. And all the trees that don't have a, I don't have to describe it. They don't have a deep blue, there I go, a deep green, beautiful, healthy color. None of these trees do. But what's really horrific about this is finding out when I posted my pictures online that this is happening all over the world. So when you look around, you see yellow trees, you see gold trees. They're supposed to be green. So now I'm going to show you something else. Besides the fact that this tree back here is all yellow and unhealthy, if you look up close, you realize it's not yellow, it's actually gold. And if you keep going closer, you look at the leaves and you go, look at that. This is completely unnatural. And this is not from fall. This is still summertime here. Okay, so you see from a distance, it looks yellow. But people aren't even noticing what's wrong with the plants. But I'm going to show you this one. The top looks really fairly healthy. And then you go down and you wonder and you go, wow, what happened here? Like, why is all this curled up and black and dying? Look at this. Look at the condition of this thing. See? And this is the Halifax Public Gardens, and never, ever, ever have they had plants do this. This isn't just happening to the foliage, it's happening to the flowers. And the more you look around, the more you realize this is happening everywhere. But remember, so a lot of this foliage you see grows very quickly, so the rain can fall, and then the foliage is replaced with new foliage. But you look around here, look at the colors. It's not my camera, look. They don't have a green color to them. It's kind of like yellow. Trees aren't supposed to be yellow. And that one right there, it's like half dead already. All the leaves die and they fall off and people think that's natural. A lot of the trees in this park have been here for hundreds and hundreds of years, but never, ever have we had a problem like this before. So this is not acid rain, folks. This is Fukushima, is what I'm guessing, is Fukushima rain in with the chemtrails material. So I think the chemtrails material is bonding to the radiation. And we'll go over here. Now these cactuses are, I don't know how old they are, they're very old, but they don't grow outdoors. They only bring them out of the greenhouse in the spring and plant them here. But if you look at my pictures from last year, you'll see that they didn't have all this damage on the skin. See that? See all that? That's all from the rain. But it's like I said about all the different plants. If you don't look up close, you're not going to see. You're not going to see anything. Look at it, like, this is not natural.
So basically, it'll shove our